now.
Starring June Lockhart, Hugh Riley, John Provost as Timmy, and, of course, Lassie.
Let me help you with that. There we are. You written your letter to Santa Claus yet?
Uh-huh. I sent it a couple weeks ago.
Good.
What'd you ask for Lassie?
A C-O-L-L-A-R.
Oh, now you know Lassie doesn't like to wear one of those things.
I know. But I thought it'd be kind of nice to dress her up when we go special places.
Did you ask Santa to bring you a new pair of flannel pants?
Dad, you don't ask Santa for those kind of things. You ask him for toys.
Well, maybe Lassie feels the same way.
Yeah. I also asked him for a B-A-L-L.
Plenty. And we've spoken about you, too. We wondered why we hadn't heard from you.
Well, right. It just don't come easy to me. Ain't it the truth, son?
That's right. Come on, let's go inside where it's warm.
Come.
Oh, my.
Lassie!
Mom, Dad, look.
I sure been hankering to have a look-see at you.
Guess Lassie feels the same way about you, Billy Joe.
Oh. Come on now, Pearlie Mae. You sit down right here and tell us all about where you've been.
Right, ma'am.
Where's your dad, Billy Joe?
The Lord seemed fit to take Pa from us. It's been the best part of a month now.
Oh, Pearlie Mae, I am sorry.
That thar city done filled Pa's chest with cold and smoke.
Me and Billy been a-grieving powerful bad. I done figured it's pretty best if we go back and join up with the kinfolk.
Not tonight. It's Christmas Eve. Can't you spend the night with us?
Oh, that's a wonderful idea.
Well, it's right kind of you, but we done got our sleep trailer, and it's best if we go down the road a piece.
Well, you'd make us awfully happy if you'd share this night with us.
Sure. And it'd give the boys a chance to talk. Come on.
Billy Joe could sleep with Timmy, and then we'd make up a nice bed for you.
Now it's folks like you that make one just proud to be a living. We'll stay.
Good.
That's well.
Go on, I want you to taste my fruitcake.
Billy Joe, this Santa Claus can visit you and me together.
Shucks, there's nothing I just done want.
Bye, Mom. Bye, Dad.
Bye, son.
Be careful, dear.
Okay, Mom.
Timmy and Lassie done give my boy a lift.
How's the fruitcake?
And you better say it's good, too.
Just the right amount of spirits in it.
Good.
Oh, poor Billy Joe. First we lost his hound dog, Mitchell, and then his pa. Now, ain't nobody can give the boy back what he done lost, but He sure needs something of his own to love. And I was a-wondering if Lassie done had herself a litter of pups.
Oh, no. No, I know we promised Billy Joe one of Lassie's pups. We'd hoped to have one before this.
See, Lassie just hasn't had a litter since Mitchell was killed here last year.
Oh, it don't make no, never mind. The boy will wait.
Oh, it's a shame. It would have made Billy Joe's Christmas. Oh, isn't there something that we could do?
Well, I think the tailor's dog is expecting a litter. I'll just go check into that.
Well, like I said, the boy purely needs something of his own to love.
That marker's about the prettiest marker I ever done saw. Bet you'd be right proud.
I'm glad you like it. Lassie and I thought it looked kind of nice.
Thanks, girl. Mitchell, brave friend. Killed in action, October 1960. Kind of makes you ache right here. I guess it's a good kind of ache, though. Mitchell sure would be surprised, me kneeling down here like this.
I bet you right this minute Mitchell's hunting possum somewhere. Up there in heaven.
I wouldn't be a bit surprised.
Calculate there weren't ever a dog like Mitchell. He was smooth as glass. Just always moved in and out of the trees like in quicksilver. He was such a good dog, and he loved me most like, and I loved him.
I remember the first day we met you. You said Mitchell was your best friend.
You said he was almost as pretty as Lassie. Hello, Mitchell. Merry Christmas.
You know something, Billy Joe? Maybe Santa Claus can't give you your dad back or Mitchell, but honest, he'll have something for you.
It ain't right you joking me like that. You know he don't know where I am.
Lassie, where is she? There's something wrong. Come on, let's go. Golly!
You just got here in the nick of time. I'm near froze to death.
Hold on, mister. We'll get you out.
Hey, Timmy, you talk this in. I'll talk the other.
Please. Hey, maybe if Lassie helps. Wait a minute, I got an idea. Come here, girl.
We'll have you free here and show us shooting. Hurry up, Timmy, show enough.
Pull!
I'm fine. Just a little cold, that's all.
I can't recollect seeing a body in a spot like that.
Well, it wasn't easy to do. Well, thank you. Well, boys, you've got quite a dog.
I think so. She belongs to me.
And I'm one of her best friends.
You know, you'd never believe how this happened. I was up on the rim there, just loading the sleigh, you see. And then, whoosh, the snowbank just gave right away. And I grabbed onto my sleigh, down we came together.
Well, I'll be dogged. If that ain't a hairy tale.
Who'll ever believe I got run over by my own sleigh? And you know, when it happened, I was just getting ready to hitch it up.
Hitch it up?
Yeah, that's right. Boys, how'd you like to come up and get a nice steaming cup of hot chocolate?
Sure.
Come on, Lassie. Come on. Oh, golly, I got a little stiff under there.
Well, my dad has a farm outside of Calverton.
Calculate, you should tell him exactly where it is.
Don't know why I should do that.
Now, look, this ain't no time to get butt-headed.
Well, it's over the next hill on the old road near the tailor's place.
Oh.
And his father's name is Paul Martin. And his name is Timmy Martin. And I'm Billy Joe.
Billy Joe.
Yochim. Y-O-C-H-I-M.
Billy Joe doesn't live around here.
But my ma and me, we're planning on spending the night. That's tonight at Timmy's.
Well, that's nice.
Special nice, since the night is Christmas Eve.
Mm-hmm.
Have you been living here long?
No, not very long. My work's about done now. I'll be moving on.
Reckon it'd be okay for me to kind of look around?
Well, of course, son. Make yourself at home. Oh, this is a figure I'm working on. You see, Timmy? Look at this clay. It comes from the hills around here.
What do you use it for?
Well, it's specially good for modeling. I'm a sculptor.
Billy Joe, what's come over you? Cut it out.
No, it hits my jaw. It done gets nervous and falls plumb out of place.
Well, are you sure it's all right now?
Well, I reckon it couldn't be better. And that ain't a spitting image of Mitchell.
I've never seen anything like it. Mitchell was Billy Joe's hound dog. And he was also his best friend.
Oh? Well, where's Mitchell now?
Oh, he was shot.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that, son.
I keep hoping that Lassie will have a litter so that I can give Billy Joe one of her pups.
Lassie? Anything so beautiful, Lassie? Honest, it looks just like my Mitchell.
Beautiful. Funny, I never thought about it that way. You know, I have many animal friends. I use them as models.
Oh, golly, we gotta get home.
Oh, I guess it is getting late. And it's Christmas Eve, and there's a lot of work to be done. All right, you kids go bundle up, and I'll walk you part of the way home. Well, I'll say goodbye to you boys here. It's been a pleasure. I thank you both. And Lassie, I thank you too.
I'd like to meet you again sometime, sir.
Yeah, like in real soon.
Well, I hope so. I've got to go back and load those presents. They're for the Rangers' children, you know, and I don't want to disappoint them. Well, goodbye and Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Goodbye. Goodbye. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Any luck?
No. No, I've been everywhere. And there's not a pup to be found.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
Well, now you stop a-fretting about it. If the Lord shuts one door, he opens another. He gave my boy strength.
Mom! Mom, Dad!
You lovely, what happened?
Well, what happened? What?
Well, last night, Billy and I did an overturned sleigh. And there was an old man pinned underneath it.
Oh. Where did this happen, Timmy?
On top of the mountain and on the other side.
Oh, well, I'm glad you were able to help him. Who was he?
I didn't ask.
There wasn't no point in asking. It was Santa Claus.
Oh, dear Lord. My boy's got fever of the brain.
Oh, shucks, Ma. I reckon I couldn't be better.
Everything's gonna be fine. Because Santa Claus knows exactly where I am.
God bless Mom and Dad and all my friends and relatives. And Lord, please do something nice for Billy Joe. Thank you. And Merry Christmas, Lord.
All right, Timmy, now into bed with you. Christmas comes early in the morning.
I just can't wait, Mom. I sure hope Santa doesn't forget anybody.
I'm sure he'll remember everybody. Good night, dear.
Night, Mom.
Good night, Timmy.
Night, Dad. Mom, Dad? Do you think, I mean, could Billy Joe be right?
Good night, boys. Time to get to sleep, huh?
Good night, Billy Joe.
Good night.
Good night, Billy Joe. Merry Christmas.
Good night, Timmy. Merry Christmas.
No peeking now. All right. Now.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
And your mom.
Well, I calculate that's the prettiest spread I ever done saw.
Oh, thank you for
the truth, Ma.
Santa Claus sure didn't forget us.
All right, everybody, come on, open your presents.
All right. Now, let's see, what have we here? Billy, this is for you from Lassie. And she's very sorry that she didn't have a puppy for you.
Oh, that don't make no never mind.
Let's see, now, Timmy, here. Timmy, there's something for you. Put it right in the basket there. And, here, Pearly Mae, that's to you from all of us. Merry Christmas.
Oh, man.
And, that's for you.
Oh, thanks.
Now, let's see. Oh, and here's one for Cully. Well, let's take it by later.
Well, what the tarnation are we waiting for? Looks just like Mitchell.
Look here. It says an extra gift for an extra fine boy. Merry Christmas, Timmy.
Thanks, loads.
And this says, to Lassie, you saved my day. Here, Lassie.
Ain't it the truth? About the Lord opening another door?
Well, I told you that Timmy and Lassie and me, we saved Santa Claus.
Ruth.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, son.
Merry Christmas, Billy Joe.
Merry Christmas, Ma.
And a Merry Christmas to you, too.